This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to look at the relationship between exponential and logarithmic functions. So I'm going to start out with a very basic exponential function. I've got y equals 2 to the x, and I want to graph that. Okay, so since there are no transformations going on here, I know that I'm going to have a horizontal asymptote along the x-axis. I know I'm going to have a point on the graph at 0, 1. That will be the vertical intercept. And I'll have another point at, actually let me mark that, 0, 1. And I'll have another point at 1, 2. And I also know this is going to be an increasing function because the base for the exponent is bigger than 1. Okay, so given that information, I can connect these points and continue the curve to make an increasing function. And I'll have something like this. Okay, and now what I want to do is look at its inverse. So to draw the inverse of this graph, all I have to do is take some points and swap the x and y values for those points. So if I have a point at 0, 1, the inverse should go through the point 1, 0. If I've got a point at 1, 2, the inverse should go through the point 2, 1. And if I've got a horizontal asymptote along the x-axis, I should have a vertical asymptote along the y-axis. It looks like it's going to be an increasing function, so let's just connect the points, and I'll have a curve that looks like this. Okay, now, looking at that curve for the inverse, what we see looks like the graph of a logarithmic function. And this makes sense, because the inverse of an exponential function is, in fact, a logarithmic function. So we've seen this graphically by just looking at the graph and its inverse. Let's mathematically find the inverse for this function, for y equals 2 to the x. So what I'm going to do, just as I did with the graph, is swap the x's and the y's. So I'm going to have x equals 2 raised to the y. And now I'm going to take this exponential equation and turn it into logarithmic form. So I'll have the log base 2 of x equals y. And to make it look more like the kind of function you're used to, I'll just swap the two sides to get y equals the log base 2 of x. Now what I want to do is take some values for x and make sure that we're actually finding them on this graph that I've drawn, on the inverted graph of the original exponential function. So let's see what happens when x is 1. So the log base 2 of 1, like the log base anything of 1, is going to be 0. So I should have a point at 1, 0, which I have right here. When x is 2, I'm going to have the log base 2 of 2. And whenever the base and the number you're taking the log of are the same, then the whole logarithm equals 1. So I should have a point at 2, 1, which I've got right here. Okay, so what I've seen both by looking at the graph and its inverse, and by actually taking the inverse of the original exponential function, is how an exponential function and a logarithmic function can be inverses of each other. Okay, so that's a basic graph. Let's do the same thing, but let's take a more complicated function. Okay, so I want to try y equals 3 to the x plus 2 minus 4. Okay, so that's going to be my exponential function. And let's see, I've got this minus 4. That's going to drop the whole graph down 4 units. So let's put in the horizontal asymptote at y equals negative 4. And let's do a small table of values to find some points. So let's see. When x is negative 1, then I'm going to have 3 to the negative 1 plus 2, which is the same as, actually, let's make x equal to negative 2. That's even better. When x is negative 2, I've got 3 to the negative 2 plus 2. Negative 2 plus 2 is 0. So I've got 3 to the 0, which is 1. And then that's 1 minus 4, which is negative 3. So I should have a point at negative 2 comma negative 3. That would be right here. When x is negative 1, I'm going to have a point at 3 to the negative 1 plus 2. Negative 1 plus 2 is 1, so 3 to the first power is 3. And then 3 minus 4 is negative 1. So I'll have a point at negative 1 comma negative 1. And let's also find out what happens when x is 0. That would give me what should be the vertical intercept. So when x is 0, I'm going to have 3 squared, which is 9. And 9 minus 4 is 5. So I should have a vertical intercept, a y-intercept, at 0 comma 5. Okay, it's an increasing function. So I'll draw my curve. And it's going to look like that. Okay, now let's just draw the inverse. So I want to take the points that I've got here and swap the x and y values. So instead of a point at negative 2 comma negative 3, I should have something at negative 3 comma negative 2. I have a point at negative 1 comma negative 1. That just stays the same when I swap the points. I've got a point at 0 comma 5, so I'll have an x-intercept at 5 comma 0. And instead, where I have a horizontal asymptote at y equals negative 4, I'll take that to create the vertical asymptote at x equals negative 4. Okay, so I've got this point, and this point. It's going to be an increasing function. So I should be able to connect these points to something like this. Okay, once again, the graph looks like the graph of a logarithmic function, which makes sense since it's the inverse of an exponential function. So now let's find out what that function is. So I'll take the exponential function and swap the x and the y. That means I'll have x equals 3 to the y plus 2 minus 4. I'm going to add 4 to both sides, so I'll have x plus 4 equals 3 to the y plus 2. And now I'm going to take this exponential equation and convert it to a logarithmic equation. So I'm going to have the log base 3 of x plus 4 equals y plus 2. So I want to subtract 2 from both sides. That will get me to the log base 3 of x plus 4 minus 2 equals y. And let's swap both sides, and I'll put it right up here underneath the exponential function. So I'm going to have y equals the log base 3 of x plus 4 minus 2. Okay? And now let's take that function and make a table of values and make sure we can find the same kind of points that we've already plotted here. So let's see. I'll make x into a negative 3. So I'm going to have the log base 3 of negative 3 plus 4 is just 1. The log base 3 of 1 is 0. So I've got 0 minus 2. That's going to give me just a negative 2. So I should have a point at negative 3, comma negative 2. And there it is. I'll make the x into a negative 1. So that I've got the log base 3 of negative 1 plus 4. That's going to be the same as the log base 3 of 3. So that's going to equal 1. Minus 2 is negative 1. So I should have a point at negative 1 comma negative 1. And that's right here. And then, let's see. I had a point over here where x was equal to 5. So let's check that out. If x is 5, I'm going to have the log base 3 of 5 plus 4. 5 plus 4 is 9, and 9 is the same as 3 squared. So the log base 3 of 3 squared is just going to be a 2. And 2 minus 2 is 0, which means I need a point at 5 comma 0, which I've got right here. Okay? So the whole idea of this exercise was to see how we have this inverse relationship between logarithms, between exponential functions and logarithms. I wanted to look at it graphically by showing how the inverse of one graph of an exponential graph becomes a logarithmic graph. And I also wanted to see how we convert from an exponential equation or an exponential function to its inverse, which is a logarithmic function. Okay? So take care. I'll see you next time.